So, on one side, I have Splunk with a lot of interesting data, DNS, proxy, email, IDS, logs. On the other side, a MISP instance with a lot of attributes. So how I can leverage the data from MISP to use into Splunk queries, searches, or to push information I have in Splunk to create new object in MISP. That was my challenge. So at the beginning, I use CSV export. This is more or less manual. This is not flexible. And hopefully, Xavier published a blog where he made a custom search for Splunk. And I thought, okay, I can take from that. So the first objective was to have an app easy to install. So you follow those steps, and you are set to use from Splunk to query MISP or to push objects in MISP. So really easy. Once you have installed, so you get the Splunk configuration for the app, where you mention your URL, the API key, etc. There is a bonus. I also developed one connector to the Hive project. So I will talk about that at the end. So from to use MISP attributes into Splunk searches. This is a custom reporting command. So it's a command you have to put at the beginning of the search pipe. So pipe MISP get IOCs. There are one mandatory parameter. Either you search with event ID, or you specify the last equal something for the duration, and then you have optional parameters to check to search only for attributes with the two IDS flag set, to specify the category or the type you are searching for, to get additional fields in what you get from MISP. And you can also point to another MISP instance. So you can define one MISP instance as being the principal one by default, but for a specific search, you may point to another instance you have by overwriting the parameters. Some examples. So the basic one is to search for the attributes which have been published in the last one day. The second is a typical use. You search for those attributes and you store into a lookup in Splunk, so you can use the lookup afterwards for searching. And the last one is also a typical use case we do. So we collect the attributes for the last 24 hours and we search in the last 3 months if we have any matching for those attributes. In this case, it's for DNS logs. The other way is to use information I have in Splunk to push into MISP. So in Splunk language, that means you set alerts. And with alerts, you can define some actions. So there are two actions defined for MISP and one for DI. So the first one is to create events. So I have, in some logs, Splunk logs, I have sandboxing reports. From those reports, I want to create events in MISP. So you have to build a search, and any field you name MISP underscore something, or FO for file object underscore something, EO, NO, etc. And you replace the star, of course, with a name of a MISP attribute. For instance, IP-DST, but Splunk doesn't like much the dash, so you make a search with MIS_IP_DST. This will create an attribute IP-DST into the event. So you make the search, you save as alert, alert action create events, you select your values for the distribution, threat level, analysis, TLP, you can put some tags, and again you can point to a different MISP instance to create the events. So quickly, this is the one I use to take from the sandboxing report, email sandboxing report, and to create events to share into MISP. So there is a lot of formatting, but it's quite simple, straightforward. A second action, citing. So you search into Splunk and you have matching values, and you would like to increment the counters into MISP. Two mode. So it's again, you make your search, you save as alert, and you make action citing. And you can either make the citing by values or directly with the UUID of the attribute, the one you can get for with the command MISP get IOC. So, So this is, so on this one, at the moment I support type 0 and type 1 for the false positive, but I use only the type 0 at the moment. Okay. So quickly, because it was easy, and I had also the use case to search in MISP, to collect from MISP some attributes, to search in Splunk, I have matching, so I want to review that into the Hive. So I create an alert that push the result of the Splunk search into the Hive alert. So here again, you fill in the parameters and you get an alert into the Hive. And to conclude, at the moment I'm working on another custom, this time streaming command. So you search for something into your Splunk repository and you can query MISP to have additional fields. So in that case, let's say you search for domain into your DNS logs. You will set MISP query field equal domain. And for any value in the field domain, there will be a query into MISP to get additional info from MISP. So this is work in progress. The output, everything is, I'm exploring a bit, so feedback is more than welcome to make that useful. And that's it. So for this one, you search into Splunk, and at a certain point you make pipe. I want to get additional information from MISP for that value. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. One issue I have at the moment is, I'm searching into MISP, and I may have several occurrence of the. So at the moment, I'm just concatenating the different return into the field, and I have to. This is. I have maybe there is a way to make multi-value fields, but I have still to search for that. But tagging, yes, could be there. Maybe more useful than the comments, for instance. Yes.